Greetings, all. It's the Devious Monkey here. I don't even know what day it is. I think it's Wednesday. Wednesday evening. I pretty much just got back from being on the road. It was a long week, even though it was still only a couple of days. I had a very, very awful night's sleep last night. I couldn't get to sleep, number one, so I didn't actually try to go to sleep until about 1:30. I stopped watching YouTube videos, and I shut off the TV, and I tried to make myself go to sleep. I slept for a while, and then I woke up having weird-ass dreams at like 4, and I don't know. It was weird. I woke up, it was 4-ish, and I couldn't get back to sleep. And I laid there for a little while, and I'm seriously wide awake. But there's no way in hell I'm getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning. What am I going to do in a freaking hotel at 4 o'clock in the morning? So I tried to make myself go back to sleep, and apparently I did, because I then suddenly heard my alarm going off at 6:05. Now, I'm a weird one, and I set an alarm for 6:05 every single day so that when it goes off, I can kind of chuckle and turn it off and go back to sleep, because there's no way I'm getting up at 6:05. And then depending on what day it is, I get up in between 7:15 and 8 o'clock. I always have a 7:15 alarm set during the work week because I need to get my ass up and get going, especially when I'm on the road or before I'm leaving, because I need to be on the road by 8 most days. I don't remember that 7:15 alarm going off. Apparently it did. I shut it off and went right back to sleep. And the next thing I knew, I naturally woke up and I was like, oh, okay. Seems like I've been asleep for a while, but the alarm didn't go off. And then I looked at my watch and almost shit myself because it was 8:40 and my first meeting was at 9 o'clock. So, needless to say, I had to get up, run around like a chicken without a head, trying to pack all my stuff up and all that shit, and get ready and check out of the hotel and get to my first meeting, which fortunately was only about 6 minutes away, but still. So I didn't shower. Forget about like being combobulated. I didn't know what the hell was going on. And I was just trying to make sure that I had everything packed and out of the hotel room, that I didn't forget anything. And then I got to the meeting. The meetings were fine today. There wasn't a problem with that. This is the second week in a row now. Apparently I have written in time to actually have food. So when I was looking to see how long it was going to take me to get to my third meeting, oh my God, I'm going to get there like over an hour early. What the hell? And then I was like, oh, I guess I must have written time in for breakfast. So I went to breakfast. I had a wonderful breakfast and just nice, chill, didn't have to rush or anything, and still got to my meeting a half an hour early. And I had to drive like 45 minutes to the last meeting. And that was a good meeting as well. The only problem with today, well, I mean, other than waking up 20 minutes before I had to be somewhere and getting pretty much no sleep last night, is that, again, it was dreary and almost rainy out. And I wasn't expecting that. I thought that it was only supposed to be crappy before I went on the road. And then when I was on the road, it was supposed to be, you know, at least partly sunny. And it wasn't. So that was kind of a bummer, because driving in the rain, especially, but driving when it's all dreary out, it was just like, meh. You know, you could just feel a little bit more and all that kind of stuff. So it was a long ass ride home. And pretty much right when I got near Virginia Beach, completely changed and started to get blue sky and sunny. So hell yeah, Virginia Beach. Now, here's what's going on right now in this studio. I decided I wanted to change things up. So I removed the ZV-1 and took the entire contraption apart, went into the magical drawers and rebuilt up a contraption here so that I am using the A7C hooked into the Atomos Ninja 5, Ninja V, and I'm, you know, using my aperture lights, aperture light above me, and aperture light behind me, because when I used the Hue light, the way I have this all set up now, I was getting all that liney shit, the flicker, and I don't know why, because I've never had that happen before. So I decided, okay, screw it. I pulled out an aperture, changed it to green, you know, for the Halloween-y kind of theme, and went with that. I also turned up the softbox from 10% to 15%, and then I have my little lights here, although they're off a little bit, but I have those set up a little bit higher as well, just trying to see what lighting is like. Now, I did dozens of tests with this whole setup, more specifically with audio, and I tried audio going into the camera, I tried audio going into the Ninja. It took me a long time to figure out how to get it to go to the Ninja, and what it turned out to be was that I had it set up correctly as far as where the cables went and which cables I had in there. The problem was the cable. The cable, for some reason, didn't work when I was trying it with the A7C compared to when I had it in the ZV1. Don't ask me. So I dug another older cable out that I didn't want to use because it was kind of bent. The corner got bent over and I used like small pliers to try to smush it back, but I didn't feel comfortable with that. And I also thought that was why I was getting all the flicker and the lines and the you know, the snowy, you know, shit. But that wasn't it either. So then as I was going through the drawers and looking through all my, you know, piles of stuff, and I found another HDMI cable that was pretty much brand new. And I stuck that in, and immediately everything came on and worked perfectly. Then, because I was trying to figure out with the audio, I again tried the audio in the camera, in the Ninja, turning up the gain on the microphone, turning off the gain. I tried all these different settings. I literally shot like, I don't know, 10 videos just back and forth to try to get the audio, and ultimately determined that the best thing for me to do would be to do what everybody else does, and that's hang a microphone up here above my head. So I took my older Sennheiser MKE-400 and put it up there on a, I guess it's a GoPro flexible clamp holder, whatever, it's kind of like a GorillaPod, only a little bit tighter. Giggity. So I put that up there, but then realized very quickly that the cable was not anywhere near long enough to get anywhere near where I needed to plug it in. So I went online and I ordered a 10-foot Rode mic extension cable, and that came in while I was on the road. So I picked that up earlier tonight on my way home, and I have it routed and all cinched down and everything and plugged in. Right now I have it plugged into the camera because it just seems to look like I'm getting, I don't know, hopefully a better signal out of it rather than plugging it into the Ninja. And that way I just have everything in there. When I'm done, then I just unplug the cables from the camera and I can and very easily remove it from the setup rather than the way it was before where I had everything built into the CineRig and it was a pain in the ass to take it apart because I don't want to keep doing that. And I also decided that I didn't want to use the ZV-1 for that anymore. I wanted to use my better camera, my A7C. So that's what I did. This is the first time I've shot with the entire setup the way that I want it to be set up with the lighting and everything. Now, I'm not always going to have, you know, the Halloween-y shit back here, but here it is. But then having the audio up there instead of like stuck right in front of me, it just wasn't working out with the way I had to put everything back together. And I didn't want to use the microphone in the camera because I don't always have the newer MKE-400 connected to that. Sometimes I use the Rode Wireless Go, didn't want to use the Rode Wireless Go in the studio, blah, 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 blah. So now at this point, I'm good to go. I think I've finally got this all figured out. And I realized when I looked at some of my, it might have been a Facebook memory or something like that. Last year, I think it was October 20th, was when I changed the studio and built these shelves and painted everything blue and all that shit and had this all ready to go the way that the blue was there before. But then I hooked up the shelves and changed all that around and made it catty corner, which is why I have the shelving the way that I have it. And lately I've wanted to change it. I wanted to get rid of the shelves and do something different. But then I thought, nah, I'm not doing that. I have other shit to do that's more important. Okay. That's it for the studio. I think it's good to go. Whilst you're looking at all this with the lighting set up the way that I have it and with the audio, let me know what you think. How's it sound? How's it look? By the way, I'm using the Sony 16-35 f4 on this so that I can sort of zoom in and do whatever the hell I want to do. I'm going to start going through all my setups and doing, you know, videos on like, here's my birding setup. Here's how it's laid out. Here's what I do with it. Here's my vlogging setup, here's my studio setup, here's my whatever the hell setup. Keep an eye out for that kind of stuff. And that's it. I've rambled on long enough. This should be enough of a test to find out how the video looks and how the audio sounds, more importantly, now that I had this all set up and I have made it a point to get myself riled up and talk the way that I talk and do all my hand movements and meh and all that kind of stuff just to see how it all shows up and what it sounds like. Okay, seriously, that's it. So that's all I've got for you. If you have any comments or questions, leave them down below. As always, thank you for joining me. Be sure to like and subscribe. And remember, kids, forward and up.